How's it going, everybody? My name is Adara. So recently I came across the Adult Swim series called Rick and Morty, and I absolutely loved it. If you haven't seen this series, please do. It has become one of my favorite series of all time. Before you watch this episode, there will be spoilers, so if you haven't seen Rick and Morty, obviously you should not see this video, unless you really don't care about spoilers. Anyways, like I said, the show is really great. It's full of existential themes, wacky science, and great characters. One that really jawed my curiosity, however, was the character Mr. Poopy Butthole, who made his first appearance in the episode Total Rickroll, which is the only episode to have an intro in the series to be different, aside from the seasonal differences, I mean. Since we see this character going and appearing on every single episode like he was always there. Of course we know he wasn't always there since we watched the show, but during the episode he's treated like an old friend to Rick, who was always around, making us all suspect him of being one of the alien parasites that is infecting the house in the episode. By the end of the episode, Morty finds out that the way to identify which of the people in the house are parasites is by remembering a bad memory of that person. In the end, they get rid of all the parasites and we see the family having dinner, when suddenly Beth looks at Mr. Poopy Butthole suspiciously and shoots him with a gun. But something very interesting happens. Surprising us, the audience, our suspicions of Mr. Poopy Butthole are eliminated since we see him bleed, and therefore being an actual person. Or living being, anyways. I don't think you can actually call Mr. Poopy Butthole a freaking human.
Ooh-wee.
So that begs the question for us. If Mr. Poopy Butthole was real this whole time, and we don't actually see him during the series until this very episode, then who and what is he? I've been pondering on this character for a while now, and I think I've come to a decent conclusion. After seeing the episode The Wedding Squanchers, which is the season 2 finale, and his last appearance on the show, as of this recording, of course. The interesting thing about the ending of the episode is that we ended while Mr. Poopy Butthole is watching television, and not just any show, he's watching, and get this, Rick and Morty, the cartoon series itself, the same series that we watch. And after seeing this scene and thinking hard on it, I came to a conclusion on the character. What if Mr. Poopy Butthole is a metaphor representation of us, the viewers of the series? Sounds a little crazy, right? Well, let me explain my reasoning. He's a character who's appeared out of nowhere in one episode, claiming that he was always around. We know that this isn't true since we, the actual viewers of the series, has seen the entire series up to that point, and we know that Mr. Poopy Butthole was not present in all the adventures that Rick and Morty has had so far. Rick also describes Mr. Poopy Butthole as an old friend who's always been there. Who better to fit that category than us, the viewers? This could fit perfectly as well with the theory that Rick is conscious that he's a cartoon character, considering his consistent fourth wall breaks during the running of the series. This would also explain how Mr. Poopy Butthole is portrayed as a viewer of the show in the season 2 finale. Because how could an actual character of the show be watching Rick and Morty, right? It would be as if you were watching your own life or the life of a friend, and that doesn't really make a lot of sense. The reason why Beth shoots Mr. Poopy Butthole is because she can't think of a single bad memory of him, and how could she, when the entire reason she exists is for our cause, the viewers, to entertain us. After all, there is no mention of the rest of the family saying anything that implies that they have bad memories of Mr. Poopy Butthole. So it could be that none of them have bad memories of him as well, but not actually thought about it. Not to mention, they forget his existence, so to speak, since he never appears near their company again. If he is a metaphor, then that could make him fit in a perfect line of both existence and non-existence in the show. Another way to perceive Mr. Poopy Butthole is instead of him being the metaphorical existence of the viewers, he is the personification of Justin Roiland himself in the show, since the character is also voiced by him. He could have created the character in a form of existence in the show, but personally I like to think he's a metaphor for the viewers instead. So, in conclusion, you and me and everybody who has seen Rick and Morty could be considered a Poopy Butthole. Well, the character at least. I hope that made sense. Kind of a weird name for us if you think about it, but it's kind of a cool theory in my opinion. And I mean, the name does fit since the creators of the show really like to use satire. So, thank you everybody so much for watching this theory. Do you agree with me? Disagree? Someone agree? Let me know your thoughts in the comments below, and if I come up with any other theories for any other show, I'll make sure to make it. So yeah, thank you everybody so much for watching. Like, comment, and subscribe to all that good shiz to help me grow. I really appreciate every single view. You can follow me on Twitter, the link is in the description. I hope you all have a wonderful day, and remember to stay determined. TTFN!